Hey y'all, we're talking about formulas, so it's time to get nerdy.
Okay, so the anatomy of a formula chip.
All right, enough of that. We don't need to do a voice. But when we're looking at a formula, there are three things to observe to learn more about how it's put together. The first is color. So in my formula over here, notice we have three colors, green, pink, and yellow. Think of those colors kind of like a passport. It lets you know the citizenship of that piece of data. In other words, what table it's coming from. I got three colors, that means I'm dealing with three different tables. Next, I want to look at the icon. So notice, next to each of these chips, there's a visual expression of what that is. Blog post has a little table, ooh, so cute. That means it's a table. Type B has a little row, that means it's a row. Nathan Penner has a little person, that means it's a nice little person column. The next thing you want to look for, number three, is how many of those icons do you see? Notice how in type B, it's one row. That means that's it. That's one row I'm dealing with. But type and doc title both have like a stacked set of icons. That lets me know that I'm dealing with several of them. So in order to get the doc title I'm interested in, I'm gonna have to give Coda a little bit more information. So when you're presented with that new formula, look for the three things. Number one, the color. Number two, the icon. And number three, how many icons there are.